career path, eventually landing in the myself in the regulatory office department. So how I came to here, so I would like to introduce here in detail. So as I told you, my initially graduation is from, I have qualified GPAT, but that time there was no any source to how to start a regulatory office, how to develop a career in regulatory office. So that was they completely blank mind. There was no clue how to start in that particular sector. So after my GPAT qualification, I have joined Bombay College of Pharmacy. I did M.Pharm in the Pharmaceutical of Analysis department. So there, after the completion of my M.Pharm, I have came to know that regulatory office is one of the department where I can pursue my career and I can enjoy that particular sector. So I started searching the particular sector in that, how to study that particular sector, what are the opportunities, what are the designations, how can I enjoy in my long-term future as well, not the short-term. I have started my planning the career regarding my long-term as well. So during that time, after completion of my M.Pharm, I have started the post-graduation diploma in regulatory affairs from the Institute of Pharmaceutical Management. So by the time of ending of the completion of that my Institute of Pharmaceutical Management post-graduation diploma, I received the one call that is GlaxoSmithKline. So it was a proud moment to me that I have started my career and eventually that I can attract the both opportunities in the market, like for MNCs, Novartis, GSK. So these are the very top 10 MNCs in India. So as you know as well, what are the top 10 MNCs are there, multinational companies are there in Mumbai as well as in whole India, there are multiple companies as a multinational. So I feel lucky to work in that those organizations and I can expand my knowledge and improve my skills. So those experience and whatever the knowledge till now I have gained, I would like to explain here. So I hope it will help you definitely and it will shape your career path as well to decide what to do after M.Pharm or after B.Pharm, whatever the area of your interest, you can choose accordingly. So, but related to regulatory affairs, I would like to present here. So, I would like to start here my presentation. That is, the topic is how to build your career in drug regulatory affairs. Okay. So, likewise, we should know the law firm along with the health authority website and to the drug regulatory affairs departments. Like, what is GSK, Pfizer, IQVIA, CTR, Cognizant. These are some companies, they have vertical opening in the regulatory affairs department. Just for your information, I have to get this slide.
What is the